Hi, we're the Psychic Twins.
I'm Terry.
And I'm Linda.
And this is part two of our Illuminati symbols used by celebrities in the music industry.
One symbol that I think is very interesting is the white rabbit. You're going to see this a lot in music videos and movies. That's a symbol of the MK Ultra mind programming and mind control that we have talked about in the past three videos. It's borrowed actually from Alice in Wonderland. That comes from the whole thing where the white rabbit goes down the hall and Alice is followed by this rabbit all the way to Wonderland. It represents the handler who gives the programmee or sleeper agent the ability to access a consciousness that's normally submerged.
And that would be the celebrity that's the musician or the singer.
Right, and that person has been hypnotized probably even through the use of torture at some point, supposedly according to conspiracy theorists. And we're not saying it doesn't exist because we think that there could be some of this going on. But we have seen evidence in Melanie Martinez's videos. She uses the white rabbit a lot. Look at her videos, like Dollhouse and I think Crybaby is one of them. Dollhouse and Crybaby. You can see she uses dolls and rabbits in almost every one of her videos. And that's very interesting because the more famous she got, the more her imagery became Illuminati-esque. And other people have kind of done that too. Miley Cyrus has done a lot of stuff with white rabbits, giant white rabbits, dancing with them on stage and in her videos. And there's quite a few people that use the white rabbit. It is a powerful symbol for the Illuminati. They borrow heavily from Alice in Wonderland in their mind control programming.
Also, the inverted cross is used by celebrities. You'll see that.
It's almost satanic in its meaning because it's turning over the Christian cross as we know it. It's a subliminal message about Satan has control, or, you know, that this is dark Illuminati energy that is controlling this artist. You see a lot of rap singers, especially using the inverted cross in their clothing. We have some pictures here.
Now, what about the triangle symbol or the pyramid symbol? We see that a lot with Katy Perry.
Yeah.
And the pyramid represents wealth, affluence, and mystery in the Illuminati. In Egypt, pyramids were ancient burial tombs for Egyptian royalty. Madonna used the pyramid a lot. She had a pyramid jacket. The pyramid represents the top-down command structure of the Illuminati with the Illuminati elites.
Yeah, the Illuminati elites were at the top. If you look at the pyramid on the dollar bill, the top part of it is separated from the rest of the pyramid that are 13 steps. But that supposedly is what it represents. And I think that this is sort of a nod to the elite again, that symbolism. Even Celine Dion has been known to use it. We have a picture of her using that.
Now, Jay-Z has used the triangle or pyramid, and Kanye West is widely believed to be in the Illuminati. His video for Power is filled with Illuminati symbols and imagery. Now, the diamond is also used by Jay-Z and Beyonce, who are believed by conspirators to be prominent members of the Illuminati. Beyonce regularly integrates Illuminati symbols into her videos, clothing, costumes, and performances.
Yeah, jewelry.
She even made the Illuminati hand symbol of a diamond during her Super Bowl performance. Drake and Justin Bieber flashed the diamond symbol, and both of them have an owl tattoo.
Yeah.
Now, what about the owl? That's also an Illuminati symbol. We see a lot in tattoos and fashion.
The owl actually was the symbol for Minerva, the goddess of wisdom in ancient times. And the enlightened ones, the Illuminati elite, see themselves as wise rulers of the planet. And that's basically what the owl symbol means in Illuminati speak.
So it represents the wisdom of the higher ups or the seniority.
The ones with the secret knowledge, the knowledge of the mystery schools. And we've talked about the mystery schools and that secret knowledge that's been supposedly suppressed by even the Church, the Vatican, and many religions over the years. So its access is only to a few, a select few.
What about the Eye of Horus?
The Eye of Horus, that's interesting. That's an ancient Egyptian symbol for protection, good health, and royal power. Justin Bieber has an evil eye inked on the inside of one elbow. The one eye hidden is a salute to the elite, and it shows the artist's allegiance to the Illuminati controllers or elite, yeah. And it demonstrates their willingness to carry out their agenda. Mm-hmm. Most of them cover their right eye.
Oh, a lot of musicians especially use this, and rap artists, hip-hop artists.
Yeah.
Eyes on Me is a single from superstar singer Celine Dion. And in order to promote the song, she covered one eye and made the classic Illuminati gesture over the other. We'll show her picture. Lady Gaga includes a lot of imagery in her videos and her album covers and photos, and she includes triangles and the evil eye. What about the hidden hand gesture we see a lot?
Oh yeah, the hidden hand gesture, that's interesting. Prince Harry, Napoleon, the Beatles, Mark Anthony, so many people have used the hidden hand, the hand sort of hiding in the jacket. It's commonly found in portraiture in the 18th and 19th centuries, although the pose appears also in 1750s to indicate leadership. The hand gesture, some theorists say, is sort of a secret signal that represents the Illuminati or Masonic beliefs. Others say the hand in the coat gesture is a common one and has been there, been so for hundreds of years, for men in a higher social class. But I thought it was interesting that in just announcing his engagement to Meghan Markle, Prince Harry actually came out using that hidden hand thing. The Beatles even used it, but I thought it was interesting. Prince Harry is now using it quite a bit, and it's almost like somebody said, do that hidden hand thing. That's really cool. You look powerful. But it sure makes him look like he's a member of the Illuminati.
I think it's more than just it's cool. I think there's more to it. Now, another thing you're going to see a lot is the shush gesture, like covering your mouth with your finger, and that means don't tell. It's a secret. There's something called twinning, where the celebrities try to look like twins and double all their images to look like the psychic twins, or like mostly us. We see Lady Gaga doing that a lot. It represents duplicity. And so you'll see it's very, very common. It's actually very easy to double your image in selfies. But Lady Gaga uses that a lot. Mm-hmm. Also, the lightning bolt that David Bowie had painted on his eye and face. Yes. Lady Gaga used that. And so the lightning bolt is also a very common Illuminati symbol. Yeah.
The snake is something you are all familiar with. Taylor Swift has kind of adopted it as her personal signature, her signature symbol.
Well, that's because everybody called her a snake. We get it. Okay.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
But she used it, and she actually turned it into a satire in her recent videos that she was lampooning her haters.
Yeah, snakes are identified actually with forbidden wisdom or knowledge, as in the serpent in the Garden of Eden in the Bible. Being poisonous and generally dangerous to humans, the snake symbol is commonly used in Western culture as a representation of evil. Rihanna actually posed in GQ a number of years ago, I think it was like 2013 or something, and a whole spread for GQ and on the cover, and she was wearing a snake and a crown of snakes, like a Medusa-like kind of crown. That was really creepy, and it was very effective, but it sure was dark for her, and I think it was quite a powerful symbol. It really did symbolize something like the Illuminati was sending a message through her. We think that they control the people around Rihanna a lot. I think a lot of the top pop and rock artists and hip hop and rap singers are, in fact, controlled in a way or, you know, manipulated by Illuminati handlers. It doesn't mean they are members or that they've actually done a handshake or gone through the programming, but
they're used by the Illuminati.
Exactly. And they may give them these things to do and say, here, you have to do that, and it looks cool, but they don't understand maybe the symbolism behind it and the subliminal messages that people are, the viewers and the readers and the listeners, are receiving. It's a very dark manipulation message of control.
Now, what about Versace?
Versace actually had, as a logo, was the Medusa, the head, severed head of Medusa, and it was covered with snakes, and it was his logo, I think, since the 80s. There's a movie about Versace that's going up this week.
Yeah.
Detailing what exactly happened.
The murder. And I really want to see that.
We actually
channeled Versace in our book, Died Too Young. Yeah. And it was a very powerful message.
It really has a very interesting history to it. Read our book, Died Too Young, to learn a bit more about that, about what happened with him and why he was a symbol for the Illuminati. We didn't talk about the Illuminati in the book, but we feel like he was targeted in a way because he was somewhat manipulated by the Illuminati powers that be. Britney Spears is shown here with Dancing with a Giant Snake.
Well, what about the black and white checkerboard? That is used in floors everywhere. You'll see black and white checkerboard floors, which symbolizes Masonic temples and good versus evil. Black and white is symbolic
in movies, music videos. I love black and white. I use the black and white checkerboard floor a lot in my paintings and my collages, actually. I've always liked black and white. I think it's an interesting graphic, but there also is mysterious meaning behind it, symbolism that people may not realize.
I use black and white a lot. This is my painting, and I've been using black and white for decades, but it actually symbolizes duality of man, good and evil. So it's used a lot in mass media and videos.
The last symbol we're going to talk about in this video is the pentagram. The Illuminati and practice and promotion of black magic is symbolized in the pentagram symbol. The pentagram was originally a protective charm against demons many, many hundreds of years ago, and some even think thousands of years ago. The inverted pentagram came to have its own distinctive meaning as a sign of evil, kind of like the inverted cross. A reverse pentagram with two points projecting upward is a symbol of evil and attracts sinister forces because it overturns the proper order of things and demonstrates the triumph of matter over spirit. So that's why you're going to see that everywhere, and even Baphomet, that, you know,
the goat
symbol is sometimes incorporated with the pentagram symbol. It's just another sign that there's some involvement with the Illuminati here, another covert message.
So the more people expose these symbols and agendas, the weaker the Illuminati supposedly becomes.
We'll see, right? So far, we haven't seen it weaken much.
So what do you think about all these symbols? Who do you want us to talk about next? Thanks for watching. Hit like and subscribe.
And we'll see you in the future.